never let me down. And then said Umar was not satisfied. He said, أوليس كنت تحدثنا أن سنأتي البيت فنطوف به. Didn't you tell us that we will come to the house and we will make tawaf? And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, بلى أفأخبرتك أن آتيه العام. And did I tell you that we will do it this year? Rasulullah Umar said, no. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فإنك آتيه ومطوفٌ به. And that was before the revelation. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives his prophet this beautiful verses of Surah Al-Fatih. Now see, this treaty the Muslims looking upon as a disadvantage, as somebody taking advantage of them, and as a source of humility, a source of dignity problems. Then what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives these verses and say, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, إِنَّا فَتَحْنَا لَكَ فَتْحًا مُبِينًا لِيَغْفِرَ لَكَ اللَّهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِكَ وَمَا تَأَخَّرَ وَيُتِمَّ نِعْمَتَهُ عَلَيْكَ وَيَهْدِيَكَ صِرَاطًا مُسْتَقِيمًا وَيَنْصُرَكَ اللَّهُ نَصْرًا عَزِيزًا. Allah says, verily, we have granted thee a manifest victory. Victory? This is victory? Now, these Muslims are hearing this, and subhanAllah, that Allah may give thee thy faults of the past, may forgive thee thy faults of the past and those to follow. Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam smiled and said, Bala ya Umar, it is a victory. And we saw all the gains that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To illustrate this to you in numbers, Muslims during Al-Khandaq, Badr, Uhud, we remember the army, the number of the fighters. These are, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam calls for jihad, everybody goes with him. So for Uhud, how many? 1,000. For Al-Khandaq, everybody in Medina got out. 3,000. In Al-Hudaybiyah, 1,400. Fatih Mecca, 2 years after that, 10,000. Hijjat al-Wada', after that, only 5 years. How many? 100,000. Isn't that victory? Isn't that how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala supports his religion? For 18 years, 1,400 to 3,000. For the next 5 years, 100,000 Muslims. إِنَّا فَتَحْنَا لَكَ فَتْحًا مُبِينًا. And that was the results of Al-Hudaybiyah. Then what happened? More blessings even came to Muslims. Abu Basir was a man from Thaqif. Now Thaqif is from Al-Ta'if. And he's, Thaqif is an ally to Quraysh. Thaqif is a Quraysh ally, and they reside in Al-Ta'if. Abu Basir is a Muslim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide his heart to Islam. And he declares Islam in Mecca, and he was coming to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he was captured. And he was captured, and they came to tell Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that you have to give us Abu Basir. Now Abu Basir is now with the Muslims, and he was captured by Quraysh, and he is to return to Quraysh to be tortured and to be convinced that he should not become a Muslim anymore. Abu Basir asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that we have to stick to the treaty, to the letter. احتسب اصبر واحتسب. You be patient, rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam give him to two people that came to Medina to take him as a prisoner, and he surrendered Abu Basir to them. Abu Basir, on the way, he started befriending them a little bit, gaining their trust in a way, and subhanallah, he was a smart guy. And then he started eating with them, and then one day he, on the way down to Mecca, he said to one of them, subhanallah, what kind of a sword you have? It's a beautiful sword. I've never seen a sword like that. Where did you get the sword? He started praising him until that man actually showed him his sword. Abu Basir was a very good sword fighter, and he killed both of them. Abu Basir goes back to Medina. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I told the story. Abu Basir kills one of them. Kills one of them, the other one escapes. Now Abu Basir returns to Medina. قَتَلَ أَحَدُهُمَا وَهَرَبَ الْآخَرِ. Abu Basir goes back to Medina, And then the other one comes to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Rasulullah, qatala sahibi, Abu Basir. Abu Basir killed my friend. And then Abu Basir came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, Ya Nabi Allah, you prophet of Allah. لقد أوفى الله ذمتك. You surrendered me to them. You fulfilled what's in this treaty. This is what you're supposed to do. After that, it was between me and them. I will not take shelter in Medina. As long as I'm not in Medina, you cannot say anything. Because you already, when I came to you, you gave me back to them. But now I'm not going to stay in Medina. And you already surrendered me once. You already gave me. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam smiled and said, you're right. You go wherever you want to go. And then he said something, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Abu Basir heard very well. He said, وَيْلَ أُمِّهِ مُسَأِّرُ حَرْبُ لَوْ كَانَ مَعَهُ أَحَدٌ. He said, Abu Basir is a warrior. Is a warrior only if he had company. Abu Basir heard that. He got an idea that he can make Quraysh very uncomfortable. He can make Quraysh pay for these conditions. And he went to a place called Sayf al-Bahr. Sayf al-Bahr is a place on that road between Mecca and Al-Medina, and it's on the way of the caravans, على طريق قوافل التجارة. And he is and it's a place that is very hard terrain, and there's many hiding places. Okay? So Abu Basir started camping there, and all these refugees, so to speak, the people that escape Mecca, but they cannot go to Medina, started coming with him. And who is with him? Abu Jandal. The man that was captured on the day of Hudaybiyah, he escaped his father, Suhail, and he joins Abu Basir, and they started tormenting Quraysh on the way, in the caravan way. They starting every caravan that passes through that place. Now Quraysh has no enemies after that. Muslims and allies are at peace with them. So Abu Basir became a nuisance. And they cannot capture him. They send armies, he goes to the mountains. They leave the army, he comes and takes the caravans. And they sent to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and they said, Ya Rasulullah, would you please cancel that fourth one? If they come to you, please take them. We don't want them back. We don't want anything. Just keep them. Just keep them. And they actually begged Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that we don't want this treaty to be the way it is. And they, the one that asked and begged for this unfair condition to be removed. And that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his prophet was telling Abu Jandal and was telling Abu Basir. لَعَلَّ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلُ لَكَ مَخْرَجًا. We humans, we are at hurry. We want to see it today. We want things to happen now. Allah and his prophet tells us, wait. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of you if you just have some patience and reliance on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the patience and to give us the faith so we can rely on Him, so we all, inshallah, the whole entire ummah can get through these hard times, inshallah. Another thing that happened was the best people of Quraysh. After all these gains, يعني بعد كل هذه المكاسب التي حققها المسلمين العزة للإسلام and these the Muslims now can walk in Arabia and say I am a Muslim and nobody will attack them and they can invite to Islam. Some of these smart, intelligent brains, minds of Quraysh started seeing the light, started feeling the truthfulness of this religion. And three people came together. Amr ibn al-As was in al-Habasha trying to go bring the Muslims back, and Islam fell in his heart while he was there. And he saw al-Najashi. This is the subject, inshallah, of next session, the kings, of the call for Islam to the kings. But he was at the Najashi when Najashi has declared his Islam. And Amr was so disturbed initially. The king becomes a follower to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then he felt that there has to be truth to that. And Amr was one of the most intelligent people in Arabia. It was Amr ibn al-As, Amr ibn Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan, was Ziyad ibn Abi Sufyan. These are the three most intelligent people in Arabia, the smartest people. And he was one of them. And he knew that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give victory to his prophet, and Islam came into his heart. While he was heading to Medina, he saw two people that he would never expect to see, two heroes of Quraysh. Khalid ibn al-Walid. I mean, the general, the armor, the one that they rely on in their wars. The hero, يعني بطل الحروب في قريش. The one that gave Quraysh its only victory in this struggle with the Muslims, he comes declaring La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah, along with Uthman ibn Talha. May Allah be pleased with all of them. Now we can start going into some of these post-Hudaybiyah phases, or we can stop and do discussion and the questions. Why don't we just do that, and then we'll see if we have some time, inshallah. Somebody has comments and any thing that they would add, inshallah. Yes, jazakallah khair. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was in Jahiliyyah, was a man that was not a Muslim before da'wah was given to him. Did he have any sins? Alhamdulillah, we studied this initially, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was protected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.